Attends, écoute, tu vas. Good afternoon and a very warm welcome to all the participants here today on the second day of the flipped classroom learning and special online e-learning tools skill development workshops for teacher at a national level. We heartily welcome you to take you yet again on the second day journey of learning a new platform where you can enable yourself to develop a class, organize it, enroll your students there, engage them effectively, give assignments, receive assignments. The agenda for the today, we are looking at Google Classroom, a beautiful product developed by none other than Google. Before we proceed on for the day, may I request everyone to kindly rise for the national anthem. All right. Extending a hearty welcome once again to one and all. Starting our session. And while we start on, I'd like to extend a hearty welcome to all the participants. And all a very special guest
for the day.
And she's none other than the principal, Meena Bagli.
Meena Bagli has been a principal in DBMS
Kadma High School for 13 years. And she has done her MA in Sociology. Of course, she's looked into business management.
And she's a trained psychologist
and a principal for the last all 13 years.
Counseling psychologist and years.
We are very happy to have her with us.
And I request her, ma'am.
Have you joined in?
Yes. Can you look into Meena?
Meena, ma'am. We request you to kindly address the gathering over here.
And She being a principal of such high number of years with
amazing experience, I think she's the best person to define and understand why it is necessary all of us to be on this journey of understanding the rational,
the concerns and the challenges
and the strong need to be in the e-learning platform,
completely equipping us with the skills. I welcome Ms. Meena Bagli, and over to her. I think my voice is echoing. One thing. I will just fix that.
Yes, your voice is echoing.
Yes, Meena, we'll just fix it.
Yeah.
Meena ma'am, I should please take over the session. Extend a warm welcome to all.
Friends, good morning, friends. I hope you're all safe and happy at home. It's a pleasure being here. Thank you, Sangeeta, for inviting me today to be on this podium. It's an honor being here. A few things Sangeeta has asked me to talk to you about regarding how the e-learning tool, all as educators and teachers. We all understand that teaching is a profession, if we have taken by choice, is a pleasure. And we all do feel today that a classroom teaching is definitely what, but online or online classes are the need of the hour today. Today have opened up so many doors of helping people and students to stay at home and get to get the information that they need, and it has helped the students get more creative. It has helped the students get more innovative. Definitely, it has made the teachers more techno savvy. It has helped us all in understanding new technology. How we teach through different methodologies and reach students in a different way. Am I audible to all? Sangeeta, am I audible?
Very much. Very clear. Thank you.
All right. Thank you. For teachers, this must have been a new thing. Obviously, not many of us are very savvy with computers. But definitely, it has helped them to become techno-savvy. And definitely, today they are enjoying the sessions that they are taking with the students. Unlike the classrooms, you may not have a face-to-face, one-to-one dealings with the students. But the classroom replaces that quite well. And teachers have adopted, at least my teachers have adopted, a lot of new methodology of, you know, presenting the same matter to the children in a different way. You know, pointing through a PowerPoint presentation, having a one-to-one discussion with them, you know, giving lessons through podcasts. So all these factors have helped the children to open no new doors. And they've also asked the children how to get information online to add to all the knowledge that the teachers are passing on to them. So all these new methodologies definitely are upgrading the teachers. It's giving teachers new, you know, online education, I feel in the long run, is going to provide teachers a lot of career opportunities. There's dearth of teachers all around today. But if we are to sit at home and take classes, today is going to open up doors for new career opportunities. It's going to be very cost effective, and it's going to be very easily accessible. You can reach every nook and corner without having to go to the person individually. And even the person who's unable to really make it to school for whatever reason, or make it to universities for whatever reason, is probably going to be able to learn And literacy rate obviously will go up if we have so many online classes going on. Online classes also have benefits for the teachers as how they will learn new things. There will be classes other than what they are teaching. There are online courses that are available now. So they will be able to upgrade themselves without having to go to different classes. While their own classes are on, while their jobs are on, they will be able to upgrade themselves and they will be able to update themselves for whatever they are doing and choose better lines for themselves. So I think in these respects, online classes are very, very, the point remains is sometimes infrastructure does become a bit of a problem in a society like ours, especially if you come to a school like ours. In my school, you will realize that a lot of many children have not been able to connect very easily. Accessibility in connection is a problem. This becomes a way of life in the long run. Infrastructure definitely is going to build up and we're going to have better connections and better reach out to a lot of people. So I do feel that online classes are a boon today because it's going to help the children to creativity and innovation to a large extent and also help the teachers to build their innovation and creativity. They'll adopt to situations. Sangeeta?
Yes, Meena ma'am. Thank
you. I think you have given me 3 to 5 minutes, yes, and I think that much time of
not
yours.
Not at all. Very, very thank yeah. you for your warm concern for how the need it is so important for us to enable ourselves, the need of the hour, and then of course it transcends to our students who may not have the reach, as you rightly said. Sometimes the infrastructure limitations are also with good due time. When the teachers are enabled, when the government is also working towards it, the Digital India has been on the move for ever since Modiji has come in. It's coming and it's time that we who empower the nation also empower each one of our own selves. So moving on from here, ma'am, and I hope you stay on for the day while we take the session on. And now over to Meena, we can't hear you. You're not too. You need.
Can you unmute yourself? I have another session to go.
Thank you,
Sangeeta. Thank you for inviting me. And I wish all the teachers out here and all the participants the very best. And I hope you stay home, you stay safe, and upgrade yourself as this is the opportunity you have. Make use of it and make the best use of it.
I also like to state that Meena ma'am has been a very, very, very a strong principal and that has created a history of very prestigious work at the work body of work. And she was invited and she has visited various schools as a part of Ukiri program, which is an initiative of British Council. So there are lots to her credit and we are very, very thankful that she could join us to encourage each one of us in this initiative, in this endeavor. Thank you, Meena ma'am, truly obliged. Thank you once again. So here we are for the day, and I hope I'm as audible to each one of you. My sincere request to each one of us before we start the session, cut off your videos so the bandwidth is better. I'm being loud and I can be still louder, but yet the voice and the background, if everybody uses it as much. So request, you all are muted, sure, that is from our end, but at your end, you please, we are requested to switch off your, we can go on this journey with a very equitable fashion, trying to reach out in the best manner to each one of us. So today, I mentioned earlier, we are here to understand what is Google Classroom. Okay, I'm sharing my screen. Starting the day of today, and first, we all know Google Classroom is a product of Google, as I mentioned earlier. So each one of us who needs to go on this journey to understanding and adopting Google Classroom needs to have a Gmail ID, right? And now the new system which has come in because of certain safeguard concerns, Google Classroom also has put in another one condition, which it says that whichever institute you as an educator is to, that particular institute is allowed to take a free. That's fantastic. Otherwise, it's quite a long process. It's and commercial purposes. But here they say the Google Suite, that's another product, a very good business product of Google company, is supposed to get that for themselves and then give those email IDs to their particular professors or their teachers. So each institute is supposed to subscribe to Google Suite. But while we do that, we can also to understand until your institute jumps onto that level. And now, since the need of the hour is strong, I'm sure all institutes will be looking forward to connect to these new endeavors to allow their talk on the journey for digital teaching and learning. So moving on, each one of us with a Gmail ID, I now take you to Google. I'm going to take you to Chrome. So if you want to work with me as a hands-on training, I request each one of you to open your Chrome. That is whether you have a Safari, Google browser, whichever browser that you may have. You can open that and we can go over there. I want to see what I'm seeing. Okay, so here is Google. We go on the Google and we type over there, Google Classroom. We go on the Google or the Safari or Chrome, whichever browser that you may have, and we open and we type over there, Google Classroom, and we get over there, this kind of thing, Google Classroom. You can even type classroom.google.com. So those of you who want to walk along with me, you can go me to go. I'm not rushing into things because it's a hands-on training. So I would request each one of you also to work along with me. And else, in case if you don't want to, you just want to watch and will, and you can do the learning and hands-on thing a little later. But those who can do it along, it would be fantastic. Okay. So, and I'm opening the Google Classroom. I'm tapping this for you. We go on the Google Classroom and then we look at the Gmail IDs. It gives you, either you can go through the Gmail IDs or straight to this Google Classroom. And if you can see this, I'm just going to put the highlight, the spotlight, which I talked about yesterday. Spotlight, as we spoke about in the Zoom, we have that lovely feature. I'm going to do that for you and get it here. And if you go up here, you see the spotlight, follow the spotlight. I'm going to use that. Go on the right side and you see these 9 dots over here, right? Next to your name, once you have logged in through your Gmail ID, right? You've got a Gmail ID, enter the Google Classroom through Chrome or to Safari or through Google. And on the right-hand side up there, you see this, tap it. Once you see is as many products of, I'm just pushing this down, as many products which are given enabled by Google for all of us. I'm also taking myself down here. Follow this cursor. You see there are so many products which Google has given. Of course, we may not as many. We may not be, and or we may be. Depends on how much connect we have with all these various particular apps. But here is my Google Classroom. Generally, find it down there because if you have not used it, it's down there. We can all bring it up to our first menu. And there we are with the Google Classroom. I hope you all are there with me. Look into this Google Classroom here. All right. Right. Okay. And now we open this Google Classroom. I tap on this. So I'm showing you two ways to enter Google Classroom. Either you go through the Chrome or Google or Safari, that's a browser. Or if you have a Google email ID, that's the second way I have taught you. Okay, two ways you have the ability to reach to the Google Classroom, which is, I hope you're all with me. I repeat, two ways we open, we go on to Google or Chrome, right, type classroom.google or, and then the Google Classroom opens for us. Or if you're on Gmail ID, we have these 9 dots over here. Click on the dots. See so many apps by your Google Classroom and you pick it up and you open it. Now, when you open it, what you see is not what you should be here. This is what you get to see, these classes. And here I have already created 1-2 classes for the day so that we do not waste too much time. But I'm still going to run the day creating a class for each one of you. I'm so slow. I hear some messages coming. You can and tell us if I'm going too fast. I'm ready to go slow. Okay, so we got the Google class. And one more thing I would like to mention here. Right now we are working on laptop, at least I am, and I'm sure most of you are as well. But the beautiful part of Google Classroom is that you can actually work and have this app and completely functional app on your mobile, whether it's Android or it is iPhone, whichever phone you may have, that doesn't matter. Only it should be a smartphone, of course. So you can definitely have a complete functionality with the best effects, barring few features, very, very basic, very, very few advanced features, but most of the features are also equally available out of your phone. And I'm going to take you on the journey of phone as well as on laptop, because obviously we don't walk around with our laptop 24/7, but the beauty part of the Google Classroom, which we are talking is, since it is in our phone, and since it's a flipped classroom, today, our whole conversation, our whole talk, our whole learning, as we have mentioned earlier, is a flipped classroom. So Google Classroom gives us the ability, gives us the functionality to have a flipped classroom. Now, you may want to know what is a flipped classroom, and to just give you in brief, a flipped classroom is a blend of various systems. A traditional system that we have always been involved in teaching earlier was chalk and paper. Then we switched to OPG format, projector, PPTs, and things like that. But still in classroom, where we are talking one-to-one or one-to-many, right? That's the way we have always been functioning since off late the COVID-19. But because of digital that we have moved, we have shifted to new ways. But the traditional way and the blended way is what Google Classroom gives, that we allow the student to do more work prior to they coming to our class. What I mean to say is, I'll explain again a flipped classroom. Imagine a class when you are a teacher, when you are a professor, a musician, a school teacher, a class teacher, a professor, a university school class teacher, whichever grade that could be. You go to the class, you have 5 students, 1 student, or 120 students. You say, all right, I'm here to teach you economics, I'm here to teach you physics, I'm here to teach you history or advertising, whichever subject. So you say, all right, today we are going to learn what are the different types of advertising, and I'm going to show you and discuss you and give you details, the features, the limitations, the benefits. You discuss all these things, and of course, in the between, if students ask a question, you allow them to ask, and maybe at the end or the in between. But the major part of the whole 1-hour session of your class, or 45 minutes or 2 hours, depending on which institute and which grade you are teaching, you are actually telling them about that particular topic that you are trying to teach them. Now, in a flipped classroom, what we are learning today through Google Classroom is that it allows you to send content, which could be visuals, which could be a PPT, which could be links to website, which could be YouTube videos, or any more of a content, quizzes, for example, some material. All these things can be included. You send them prior, and they are expected to read and go through this content at home or wherever they are living, whether they're in a hostel or wherever. So before they come to the class, they're supposed to be have read, shared with them on the topic. If I'm saying advertising is my subject, but then the what is advertising, why it is a need, what are the objectives, why it is necessary, or what are the limitations or benefits to the society, and so many various things, features of advertising or things like that, various advertising agencies. So all the things that I want to send them, they are expected to have read it, gone through the videos, gone through the content I've shared. And when they come to the class, I, as a teacher, am not expected to teach all that what I've already shared. What I'm supposed to do is ask them concerns and question answers, or do a project with them based on the content that I have shared, right? So this is what is flipped classroom, and that's what we are learning in the Google Classroom today. So you have to understand why we are doing Google Classroom. It is not just learners doing it, but you have to use it to effective way to flip classroom running. Now moving over quickly to Google Classroom, we are in short form, I call it GC. So we go here and we look here that I'm going to show you on the class. Here it is, the classes, you tap it, it opens like this, it has a calendar, it has your various and things like this. And when you do on the classes, you enter the Google Classroom, the setting over here. You will not see these two because these ones have been created. I'm going to create a new one for you over here. And you go on the right and do plus. When you tap on that plus icon, you have two options here. You have a join class or create class. What does this mean? Join class is for the student. Because obviously, if you are a teacher, professor, we definitely need a student, whether within our city, whether across our city, within our nation or international, so means international, city, community, whichever is huge because you are a digital mode. So if you are a student, then where you will join the class, teacher, right? Then you also get to create a class. Another aspect of join a class is when we set an invite. Next step that I'm going to show you. And then invite to a collaborative teacher. You want another teacher, a guest lecturer. Like today we had Meena ma'am to start the day with us, and she was honor for us. And you want her to speak and join us in the class. We also let her go into this, and she can join the class provided we open a code for her, which I'm going to teach you. So let's say we start creating the class. Please tap on creating class. And here, so this is a new thing which has come up. Are you using Classroom at a school with students? If yes, as I mentioned to you earlier, please have your institute sign for the G Suite for Education. And they sign it, they give you a particular email ID which is subscribed through the institute via G Suite, and all the professors get that ID, and you can work through that to reach the students of that particular institute, or you can have another ID to reach beyond as well. So we just over here, I've read and stood, but I'm not using Google Classroom at a school with students. Right now we continue with this here. And here this opens up to create a class. All right. Now create a class. What name do you want to give the class? We say, okay, since right now we give any title to the class depending on what we are teaching. Are we teaching cooking? Are we teaching stitching? Are we teaching physics? Are we teaching history? Are we teaching nature trends? Are we teaching advertisement? Are we teaching science? Whichever. So since today we are learning online learning tools, I will just quickly get this thing. Online e-teaching class. Last name we have to give, because what happens, there could be many classes when the student joins. He might want to see, you might have more than one class. You could be teaching in class, you could be teaching also history teacher. So you also need to understand which class your session is scheduled. It's important you give the class. Now section, there's a one section A, B, C, D. You mentioned that, let's say we have a section A. It could have two sections, we leave it teaching. So here we can write, we are teaching tools for teachers, E2, let me call it E2 for teachers, right? And room, what is the room? It's just a numerical number we give, like in the classes, schools when you go, or the colleges when you go, you have a particular room assigned when I go. So it's just a particular room number to give a familiarity. Also helps soon, once you start of functioning on Google Classroom, then you will actually have a full timetable with your room 1, room 25 is my online teaching class. Once you get functional, so it's very important. Familiarity is one only initial aspect. Later on, your full functionality on Google Classroom, these are the ways you can understand. So let's say my room is all right, and here you tap it, create, right? You create, tap it over here, and well, what you see is, it is creating the class. You can see it's taking a few moments. It is creating the class, and soon the class is going to get. They go online teaching and such like that. So here is a look at it. Take a time for it to get open. Online teaching, A section. This was a teaching before. To go to the other class, then I see another class. What I'm trying to show you is through the same method of creating classes, you can have as many classes created. You can be teaching, let's say you are teaching in a school or a college. Let's talk about college. There are 3 years. Junior school, first year, second year, third year, or 11th standard, 12th standard, or in a school, they are standard 1, 2, 3 to 10, as many. So you can have big, and through the same system of creating classes over here, the way you're looking at this, the way you see me over here, my classes are there, 1, 2, 3 classes I have got, and I've deliberately kept over here. I started using Google Classroom in year 2017-18. That's my class earlier times, and people have graduated and gone, and only few kids live, but we had good 63 kids in this class. So that's the time when I started, and the class is still retained with me. It's there in Drive as well. And this is the one we created. These two also have been created. This we created as a demo class, but I'm going to also work along with you over here. Now, opening this class, if I see this, this is what you get with the class which I just created with you, right? On top, you will see these 4 things. Please look at this red spotlight. This is where my cursor is with you. You have a stream. You have class. You have grades. So, full functional classroom by itself. The beautiful part is can create. I have some people here in this class, in this session, who are running tutorials. So on this also, you can have a full functional tutorial digital. You need not rent a place. You need not buy a place for your institute, for your college, for your school, or for your kindergarten, for your music classes, work on it, giving assignments, receiving assignments, enrolling students, and so on. You have these 4 things. What do we do generally stream? Is what the various classes is. We start with that. On stream, what do we do? Stream is basically to give us an idea what the class is and what we can add into the class for the benefit of students. For example, here, while I go down to show you stream, let me show you what this is. Now, this is a theme. The theme, what I'm teaching the class, it gives you a benefit to understand this is what it looks like. And if you go on the right, you see a select theme. You have the ability, you have the function by Google to change the theme. So I can select a theme. The one which was given is by default, but I can change. Let's say if I'm doing online teaching, so I think this would suit me more appropriate. And if I'm teaching, let's say something, I'm doing an arts thing, sometimes then probably cooking, let's say, for example, cooking or music, right? Or here it is table setting class or painting class, drawing class and painting class, right? You have the functionality to go into as many, delve into as many fashion, shoes, cooking again, or things like that. You can choose English history, general, math and science, art, sports and other. You can find out whichever theme you want is, you can do it. And whatever is, you can upload a photo. My suggestion is to get since we are talking to a computer and the students are not in physical connect to us, they are not on one menu, one-to-one idea, that you upload a class photo over here. And that's very easy. I'm sure you all must have met some time or had a class photo and get the students to send you photos together and club them together and do on the digital mode, make a class photo. And you see over here, we can upload a photo. If I do this and I can select a photo, either up to gallery, select a photo from your computer. So if you have a class photo, the class that you're teaching, 60 students, 10 students, 5 students, whichever class that you're teaching, you can go to your computer and probably select a Clutter, let's see if I have to select, I can perhaps select. All right, I am selecting. Screen one. Let's say I'm selecting the screen one, which is the class that we started with yesterday, and we have this photo getting uploaded. And I just bonus to as much space it allows me. I pull it up. There you go. Right? And what you do is you say down over there, you say select class key. You just tap on the select class key. Right? And soon it will change to what photo you want. You want it as per your student class and things like that. So that's first thing. First, it just gives a familiarity. It's like the small children you're talking to. What you're adults, it just gives a sense of connect with the teacher. So it's a good idea if you do that. Now, when we start over here, we say generally on this board, which is a teacher board, we generally give a little welcome note to our students. So let's say doing that, we write over here, share with your class, and let's say I say welcome to one and all your students for the learning and developing e tools for them. Then I could write something like this depending on what thing, or you can e tools, software learning, whatever that you might like to write, you are welcome to do that. Now you do that, you have to note whom does it go to. It tells us either you can look up here. It tells us I can send it to all the students. I'll tell you how we get things to the students. Or it asks me, can I send it to all the classes? Supposing you are your teacher, you're just starting the year generally in June or the early month of the year. We start with new classes and you have enrolled for made classes for year one, year two, year three, or standard. 8th standard, 9th standard, or if you're a musician or a singer or a dancer, whichever, you've got three classes over there, one from children, small children, adults, and youth. So all the three classes, do you want to send the message to all then? It asks you. And if you want to send to all, you can just pick to all, pick all of the classes that you have. And if you say, no, I want only to send to my one particular class, then you can just send to that one particular class that I'm sending only to this. I'm sending to, it gives you the ability, you have a choice. If you have 10 classes, you can send the details in. Students, there could be a broad sending to all. Example, exams are coming up. I wish you the very best, my dear students. Prepare well, right? So if you want to put it, that needs to go to all the students that we have enrolled. And supposing you also want to send it to selective to some particular message, which please improve your grades, or you might fall into trouble because of you not getting to clear your grade and may not be allowed. To only 10 students out of 60 batch, you can identify them here only to them. So it's a, but again, next day at all, select many or select few. So that's one thing. So while we do this, here we go down there and we look over here, we say post, right here, post. Now, when we post this, in a new year, welcoming students to a new class, or as a principal, I may get a class to all my teachers, right? I need to add some syllabus if I'm a teacher, so that I'm teaching a particular advertising class and I want to send them here, this ad. Look at over here. This ad, we click on this ad. We open this Google thing. Here. We put the ad and We have Google Drive, Link File, YouTube. Whatever that you as a teacher, as a professor, as a principal, whatever that you want to attach the details that you want to send syllabus so that the teachers are ready and start preparing with the holidays. Today, we are all are working out of home because the colleges and schools are shut, but you want the teachers to start preparing their lessons. Because what the here is where you start attaching them. So let's say I open this and I go to my Google Drive and it opened my Google Drive and I say out of my Google Drive I want to attach e-commerce, right? I'm teaching a subject on e-commerce or a survey on whatever that I need to do on this. I do that and I say tag over here, add. Okay, so when I do this, it's inserting files using Google Drive. And only say there's a folder that how many options it gives us in the Google Drive, what I want to add. I can do this. Right now I'm adding this topic, or I can even add, if I can show you some images also. Let's say I want to send, we just had the national anthem, for example. So let's say there's a school anthem which has been developed by the school or the college, and you want to send the two teachers so that they can start practicing, learning the lyrics. And so when the school opens, this is some new thing that has come up, learn it. You can use any one of the things that you have as a principal, as a teacher, and send it ahead. So that thing done. Now we go back to here, and when you add those things, whatever that you need, syllabus, content for your teachers, for your students, whatever that you need to welcome them, to send them a message, you add this, this word, this tab, post. And there it gets posted to which as many students or the classes that you wanted to send it ahead. That's just to understand how we can start a class, create a class, and create the theme. We talked about creating a class, selecting our theme, coding syllabus, content that you want for your teachers, for your students, and so on. Now we are going to look at how to enroll our students, how to get our students enrolled within these. We have created a class, obviously there's no class which doesn't have a student. So we are going to look up over here, and then we are going to say enroll students. Now again, please look up at this, the image that we have put up from here on the left-hand side, right? Look at my side, you have something red as class code. Tap on it and enlarge. This is the class code of which class? Online e-teaching class. So if you have five classes going on, each class will generate a different code. A student who gets this code will not be able to join your cooking class or your history class or your physics class for that matter. So every code is unique for that particular class. So here you go. What you can do with this code, what I'm trying to extend to you information is how to enroll your students in your, you have created the class, you have put up a theme matching with the topic that I've done it, you put the details in your class, section, class and all, now enrolling students. Copy this. Control C, we copy it. So once this is copied, you can use this copy, go back to either through email or copy, or you can even write down both options. They can just expect here. You can copy it, copy paste it, and send it via email, which I'll show you how to do. Or you can write it down with a pen and pencil, put it in the WhatsApp messages, whichever way. I'm sure you have a class group to be formed, or that is a CR, that's a class div, and you can send him this code, which he can forward to all the other students of that particular class. That's one. There are a couple of ways of enrolling students. That's way one. Let's look at the other way. All right. That follow my cursor. I'm going on the right side here. Up there, there's a setting. We all know this means a setting, right? This icon is a tap on it. The moment you tap on it, it opens you with the class details, which is important. So here it shows it's online eating class section. So you know that you're on the right side. Scroll down. Just scroll down. We come to the general. It's a general class code, stream, classwork on the stream, and deleted items. We'll talk about that later. Right now we're talking about role instruction. Class code. Same code you find over here as well. The same code you find. All drop down menu, tap it, display, copy, reset, disable. Now this it gets into a bigger one. Same purpose. Second thing it says, you can copy it. I explained earlier, copy, write it down, send it through email, send it through your WhatsApp or message group, whichever way you want to communicate. You can send it to your college office, and if the office or school office is administering them, they say this is the office, we have to send it ahead. If it is in the whole school program, if you're doing an individual, all the students that you want to enroll, the email IDs must be there. Like for example, right now for this course that you are all in, we have all your email. I can use your email IDs to send this code, and you will, each one of you, receive within your email this code saying, Dr. Sangeeta Mukherjee is inviting you to join the online e-class with this code. And if you tap this code, you'll be able to join through Google Classroom, provided you have a Gmail link, and you'll be able to join that. Okay. Next thing it also tells us. We can change it. If you're happy with this code, for whatever reason, we can make our own code and disable. What is the meaning of disable? Let's say you wanted 20 students in the class and you don't want any more. Because you're teaching a particular subject, robotics, you're talking automation, and you want only a small little class, or you have 100 students, you don't want more, you can disable. That's it. Then you can, once you disable, this particular code will not function to allow other unauthorized students to join the class. Or you can say, okay, we are starting this, like we have started this web series, and we said the series are starting on 28th. So all those who wanted to join, I send you this, and you join it. And after 29th, I disable it. That means no further students I enroll because the classes have started. So you have the facility, enroll class students on level. I hope I'm clear. How we enroll, two options I repeat. One, well, I'll go back to you, but very important that you understand how you enroll the students, because no class is complete if we don't have students. What are we going to do with the class if you're not teaching? The whole idea, we go on this board, bulletin board, the theme that we have put up, tap here, you get your this thing, the code, copy, write, paste, send email and things, right? Or then you can go on the settings, as at the right side here, my cursor is going right side. Settings, you get a class details, you can looking at, scroll down, class code, tap on it, display, copy, reset, or disable. You don't want more, so disable it. I hope I'm clear to each one of you. Switching on ahead. All right. Now, okay, when I say I have got this thing, these three buttons over here, find generally in the Google Classroom, these three buttons are enabled at almost every level that you look at, right? Let's say today I have given this notice to my student that you're welcome, and I've written the code has been sent. Now you want to change this thing. The code has been sent and everybody can enroll by 1st of June. After that, the classes will start and the fees will fees. If you are late to fill the exam fees, then generally you know, tells us exam fees, and you probably have a late fees and 100 rupees or whatever extra fees that you know are still paying. Again, on this bulletin board, you can send the message for the students. So this bulletin board, how we can edit it. It doesn't mean you have sent one message and second time you can't send. Press these tiny three dots, right? Edit, delete, or copy it. So you can edit it, and you can a new fresh message. Let me edit it for you. And now I say, okay, I delete this. exams are starting from 15th June till the form or late fees of rupees 100 is applicable after 5th June 2020. Sorry, I'm just admitting my mistakes of spelling. Just doing it quick. So suddenly the whole system changes and you can again have this sent to the whole class, right? So this, I just wanted to show you this thing. Now moving on, we now quickly look at the next things. Sorry. We are now enrolled our students and now we're going to look up. We have got here people. I'm going to now talking about enrolling more teachers as guest teachers, as other teachers who I have other teachers that want to call in for us. So here we also have the teacher level over to do it. So not only the students we enroll in joining, we also have teachers who can join in teaching. In one advertisement class, for example, or history or economics or teachers, you can have two teachers teaching the same subject. Likewise, I do this, I send them an invite here, invite teachers. So let's say I'm inviting Sangeeta Makkad, and I pick up one email ID and it I send to her and I send the invite and she gets invited to join my class. And it says over there when she receives the email that Sangeeta Makkad has invited to join the online teaching class for the teaching online tools. And all the same way. You see this G plus, tap it here. If you have the name and the emails of your students with you, right, when they have come in and they have paid the fees of the college that you're working or the school they're working, but you're joining in an online class, all that you need to do is write their name over here and join them. For example, I'm writing over here, A R J N H Harjmera 7 at gmail.com, right? I'm sending this to the student and he can hear this and I can go down. It says invite. So three ways, beautiful ways to get your teachers also to join in your classes. You could be a principal, you could be a tutorial head, and you're running and you have different teachers teaching in the different classes that you have created. And you can call in teacher to speak in that class while you are managing the complete setup. So Google Classroom gives you two factors, either as a teacher or as a principal or as a manager of the complete setup in which you have classes to get students enrolled, but other teachers coming and teaching. So beautiful way, it's a lovely facility to go ahead and create a business for yourself if you want in education field extending or being a teacher teaching. Either way, a lovely way. So you have all this. So I find that a lot of students, two of them have joined and I'm very happy. If Arjmera also joins in, that would be nice. And you can arrange the thing A to Z, whether you want to have sort by last name, sort by first name, it gives you the option. So now going up, so we have done the stream. Here, follow my cursor. We have done the stream. We have done the people, that people is joining the enrolling a student and enrolling a student one. Now let's go classwork. I'm stepping three things we had promised you that we are going to teach you over here. One, creating a classroom full setup, how to create a class within Google software to be the flipped classroom functioning. Second, our work was that we had promised you that we are going to tell you how to enroll, get the students to the class. And we also told how the teachers you can collaborate with to create a full functional setup of yours where you may not be the teacher, but run a class of your own and find other teachers of you. So that's another way to look at it. Now we are looking at how you assign work, that is give homework, give assignments, give your content, you give assignments to the students. And then will be when the students receive it, how they will submit. So two things we are looking at, assigning work to your class here. We touch this as the class work. This is what we open up, right? While I start with this, I would also like to mention that in the Google Drive, whichever Google Drive email is connected with, there's always a Google folder, a classroom folder created, and it stays for years. If I have my class of 2017, if I, you see here, I have this 2017 class here with the class graduated and gone ahead, right? I still have their folder, the assignment they subjected to me, submitted to me, the assignments I gave to me, and so on and so forth, all the details. All these things, when you create a new class, old class, 10 classes, 15 classes, I'll show you that as well, all get stored, and they don't just vanish off. The content gets stored in your Google Drive under a folder called Google Classroom. So it's very essential for you to know, because if you want to quickly go back to Google Drive as well and look into their work. All right. So here I'm looking at assigning students assignments. Now we are going to the classwork. It tells us create assignments and questions, use topics to organize classrooms into small modules or units, order work the way you want students to see it. So creating assignments is when we are giving them assignments, we give them questions, practice questions, questions to answer or things like this. Or when we are creating topics, let's say you're teaching history, history of the world, history of India, you're teaching economics, you're teaching advertisement, since I deal with mass media, you're teaching advertisement, and you said the first topic of the day we're talking is, what are the various strategies or the models of using advertisement to the best benefit? That could be a topic of the day. A topic could be, what are the various advertisement agencies? So you can create these topics, and I'll show you how to go about that. We'll work on it. And you order the way. What does this mean? Order work the way you want students to see it. That means that when you create these assignments, you can toggle them. They go up, they can down to bring to the students' immediate need what work is yet to be done. If there's assignment left and they have not submitted, it just gets into function. Let me show you how. We will first say, go on this blue icon. We hit classwork. There's a blue icon plus. Tap it. When you tap it, it tells us these few things: assignment, quiz, question, material, reuse, post, I'll touch on that, and the topic. So since we are going to break our subject that we are teaching, online tools or history or chemistry or whichever, music, I'm teaching advertisement, for example, or I'm going to talk about topics. So I tap the topic and I say, okay, I'm talking about advertising, and we do ads. See here the ad, just tap on it, and your topic is ready, right? Your topic comes under the classwork, it is shown as advertising. And let's create one more topic here. We again go to the topic, and we then say, okay, we're talking about advertising. We talk about, let's say, food, immunity building, B-U-I-L-D-I-G, immunity building, and nutrition you want to do, and that is the topic that you're looking at. You also we are talking about this. And then, and yet again, another topic that we want to do, and we say, okay, here we are, we're talking about, I'm talking about now small schools, clubs, or we say alphabets. This is right, I'm catering to small students at schools, kindergarten schools also. So here, so I'm creating this, showing you in one way. Of course, alphabets will not be taught to the one who are learning advertising. I'm just showing, because we have limited time and only one way, doing alphabets catering to small children. You use alphabets, you say numbers, whichever topic, you say parts of the body, and you're doing bigger schools, colleges, students, then you talk about different things, advertising, journalism, mass media, press laws, whichever topic that you'd like to do under the unit that you're assigning. So here are the topics created. Now, what next we do in it? Let's say I'm hitting the word advertising. advertising is ready, but I have not put any assignments or anything in that. On the side, you see there are three topics: alphabet, immunity, and tick. So when I say alphabet advertising, the topic I would want my students to see and start work on while they're at home, not going to colleges and schools. I just drag it up. I drag it up. What did I tell you? I will show what is this reuse post. I could have written content on here. I want to resend it to my last year class also and current class also. Whatever content I will write it, it will be sent to both the classes. Would I say reuse post, right? Can do that. And I can toggle. If this is a subject I'm going to start immediately when I start going to the school or college and or immunity building or itself, I can just drag it up. That means what goes up is the immediate attention what the school student is expected to see. So we get the advertising above again and we say, all right, to give you work in this. And here we have topic has been created. Now we can use any of these things to give them assignment, quiz, question. Let's say I start with the material. It comes the material, tap on the material. Did you get it all? What did I do? I'm not rushing. I go back. Let me redo with it. Advertising, there's a blue up, there's a plus over there. Google Classroom is a very beautiful functional. It allows you to go back, come ahead, and at your pace. So don't worry, you're not going to get lost in it. We can go slow at your pace when you're practicing after the session is over for the day. Tap on it and you say assignments or material or question. I'll show you a few of them. Let's say material that they're going to use. The material I'm saying, okay, advertising for Mother's Day, right? Day advertising that we're looking at, and then discuss the strategy used, right? So there's advertising for Mother's Day. What is the topic that we're looking since we're talking about advertising? So Mother's Day, how it has been utilized as a forum. And what are the strategies used to make a product the companies are selling or the companies are endorsing? How are the strategies they use? They brought in celebrity endorsement or the product they're selling. We are all looking into this. So this is a description. You can use details. You can even say discuss the strategies used with a group of three students, right? Okay, right. So you can have 3 students, 10 students, depending if you have 100 members in the class. 100 students, say, okay, every group will be of 20 students. You have only 25 students, make 3 students. Your option, brainstorming what you say, right? They brainstorm at home. And then we say, okay, add. Now, under add, the content, the material that we are sending them under Google Drive, link, file. This is the content you as a teacher, you as a professor have to keep ready. So the flipped classroom through Google Classroom allows 2 ways. One, the student to start learning on their own about the content that you have to teach them. Secondly, your work should be ready with you, right? So let's say we are adding, I'm going to take you on YouTube, for example. I hit the YouTube, it opens the YouTube. It tells me either I search a video or I add only the URL. So if I have the URL with me handy, which I'll also show you how to do, or you can search the video. So let's say Mother's Day video, right? Let's hope for some mother opening it. And here we go. YouTube gives us within Google Classroom to open. So why did you have connected with internet? Sorry, that's very important. The Wi-Fi internet speed has to be decently good, right? In case this is not, then of course you can save in your hard drive your assignment links, your material to read. Not necessarily you have to send the YouTube. I'm just showing a few things out of this. So this becomes very interesting for the students nowadays. But in case for some reason your network is not the best in that time, you can in your out of the hard drive you have, out of the desktop you could have saved some material to read. You can attach that also, which I will go now. So let's say Mother's Day Studio video, we have so many of them come up. and we will say their TikTok videos also, their Mother Day video, what will you say? We just attach short film is also there. And I think a daughter and mother will probably attach that. Lovely. The awarding emotional. So we are looking at Mother's Day, and we are trying to understand through this YouTube how they have created it. So that gets it directly. I did add, I went on the YouTube here. The YouTube opened within the Google Classroom. You are not hunting it anywhere out the classroom. You write which video you want. Let's say you want a video on mother, right? Video on mother. Now you're not talking Mother's Day, you're just talking mother. So it again brings to the Mother's Day as well. So necessary, the keywords you have to figure it out. Sometimes if you do not write Mother's Day, it will bring us to the key terms and you can almost be there, right? So it gives us a Mother's Day role. So many videos, you can always do it. Another one way you to do it is a URL. If I have the URL ready, I can directly post it. How do I do it? For example, let me take you over here. In my Google Chrome, that's up there, see up here, my Google Chrome or Safari, I open a new video and over there, I just write YouTube and YouTube opens up and YouTube, when it opens, I tell it which video that I want. I want to look into that. Yeah, lot of videos have come up. Whichever, let's say you're teaching Google Excel file or so many things. There's so many things that you can use of it. Gulzar, poem sikhare. You're teaching poems. You're singing songs, right? You're talking music. Any one you can pick up depending on the topics. So here we are talking mother. Specifically, right? Mother, right? Mother, their songs have come. Mother, their status, card, gifts, there are thousands of things that has come. And I can have a Mother's Day song. And out of this, identify one kid's song, whichever you're teaching small children. Preschool, I think something of this animation would really make a good impact on the kid to be happy to sing something like this. But trust me, when I teach senior students in the college, I also pick up, and when I'm teaching, what I'm telling them is, this is another new format to connect to the audience. Advertisement could be reaching to broader sections of society. And this also works well with the youth today, right? Ma, Arijit Singh. So you can pick up anything and you can download that. And let's say I picked up Arijit. I don't have to open his video. All right. If you can see here this, please look up here the URL. I'm copying the URL here. And then going back to my classroom. And in the link, all I'm just adding the link here. And add link. Okay, so these are the things that we do. So you can add as many things from the Drive, Google Drive, and all these things can be added. I will not stop too much. You can go Google Drive, file from the hard drive, Google Drive, and what? Okay. So now quickly we are looking at, I'm going to take you on how some, I think some members are writing that they want to see on the phone as well. Let me quickly show you that. I'm just going to get my phone connected. So I hope you understand when you do this, and I'm going to show when you're given these assignments over here, what it also allows you to do is, you need to give me a couple of minutes. It also has create, you can give in slides, drawings, and all these things is also there. And then it says, if I've added a file from my drive, let's say I've added this drive of, okay, here's the IMC. In PPT. Just a second, I'm five. Okay, unethical advertisements, right? That is also there. You can upload that, or you can do it on. Let's say I've opened this note. Okay, I've shared a file, a research paper I've shared in which they can read and understand what are the research paper conferences that I have. Now, when it opened over here, what you also need to see over here, I can put the details of the student needs to submit me these assignments, right? You can, and if you want to cancel an assignment, you can just go cross and assignment gets canceled. Yeah, go on. This is for which classes? It says for, please follow this on the right side I'm showing. We have to now send it to student because you have uploaded the assignment, but you have to send it. So online, does it need to go to only online teaching or does it go to also the other class that you've created? So I say I want to send to only online. Then it tells me, does it need to go to all the students, Arjun Mehra, Mudassar Sir, Radha Raju, that the students have enrolled for the class, or do I need to send to only Mudassar? I have a choice over here. I can say only Mudassar or no. Then I say this and I cross out Arjun, I cross out Radha. But would I want to send assignment to all? Then I say all students. So you could be giving different assignments to different students and likewise upload and make the changes over here. All students, selected students, one assignment to one student, another assignment to another student. You can just play around with this. It's a beautiful facility. So I have marked here right now all students. You have a choice to do. Then topic, we have said we are doing advertising. It gives you also the topic, the alphabets, immunity. You have to mention which topic you are doing. So I've given advertising. Then it tells me, should I hear few things? Very interesting. You can post the assignment today, or you can save as a draft. You suddenly had some work to do and some assignment has not been completed, you want to send. You can save the draft, re-add the assignment, or you can schedule it for another day. Today is 29th. I want to send it on 1st June. You can schedule it over here. And it will say schedule material. It will help me. Okay, I want to set it on June 1st at 8 a.m. I want to send it. See, the time also comes up here. So if I don't want to send it today, but I told my students by 1st June, I'll be sending assignments. I can schedule it 1st June, 2nd, which the time, the whole month comes. If I want to go in July or whichever, or if I want to send it on 30th May, right here. So you have a timetable here. The calendar here and the time you want to put it, you can manually put 8 o'clock, or you want to put 12 p.m. and so on and so forth. You can schedule it. So that's one beautiful thing they tell us, that we have given this work. And now when you see this, you can see the assignment that you have given have got uploaded under the advertising section. All the three assignments, the mother-daughter thing, the Arijit thing, the research paper which I put, all have featured over here to be sent to my students and the classwork. He received all this, Arjun Mehra, Mudassar and Radha Raju. They would have all received it in this. In fact, I wanted to show while this thing, the student view also, but right now because of lack of time, I'm there, but this is what we're looking at. Now I'm going to quickly jump you, likewise you do in all these things, quickly going to jump you to the phone thing. I promised you I'm going to show. I don't want to go back saying I have not shown it. I promise you. And yeah, okay. The grades thing is also there. And let's say when the student submits you these assignments, and you see when the student submits you, here I'll just open the grades. The student has submitted. It shows over student submitted. I'm going to show you quickly from other class where I have got students submitted. Here we go. I take you here. And assignments are here, and the students have submitted some of them. I made assignments in the Google Slides. These are the various things. I've graded them. Graded means they have been graded. When the student submits, you get it in your inbox. You get in your inbox over here under the two section right here. This is you get it. Track your progress. This is the student work that you get it. And you can grade the assignment had been graded by the teacher. This is the student outlook, what I'm showing you. And the student is over there. They get this assignment. Sangeeta Makkar posted a new assignment, advertising notation. Sangeeta Makkar has said. And what the assignment says, the student has done it. Then they upload it over here, your work. They get to upload it or see over here. Let me go slow once again. This is, I'm showing you the student. Now I have a student. I'm showing the student how they will see it. the student gets these advising, and the student gets these things, and when they have to do the work, it goes up, and then they have it their work. They have to submit their work. They have to go on the right, this on the right side of the screen. Here, my students have already submitted, so I'm just showing you how they can add, create, or resubmit. They can do all of these things by tapping on this. So this gives them an idea, just to look at the window when you kind of look at how the students are viewing this. They can open this. Okay, one second. And here they open this, and then they watch it, and then they what we had told them, they watch the video and discuss it with your group of three people or four people, or we don't want to discuss, just write your own personal comment, what your take on this. And after they write it, they upload it over here. They add their through their Google Drive, they add the link, they add their file, all these things. The students, I'm showing you the students view. They upload it over here and it gets up. They write submit, resubmit. And then when I receive it, let me show you, I have received it. I can comment quickly. Let me show you. When I receive it over here with my students, it will feature over here under the classwork, right? I will get my students' work over under the advertising, and I can grade them. I can I can show you better. Yeah. Can you get the phone on meantime? Okay, I'm going to now show this part on the phone to you. There is one. Yeah, we are switching to the phone view now to take you further, so that both these things can be done together. Right now, I'm on phone, and but you can definitely do from the other one also. Just a second. Yeah. So how do you do that? I'm just showing you on my phone. If you see, I'm holding my phone over here, and I'm just showing you how my phone is going to look when I'm working out of this. This is my phone, and here we go. Quickly select my Google Classroom. If you see, I have got the app downloaded in my phone. I tap it. It opens. Now, if you see how many classes I have over here, I'm just scrolling down the classes, down there, as many classes you can see, right from 17, 18, when I started my journey, with the Google Classroom, and right up till the last class that I was conducting was in 2020 social science class, if you can see. This is the social science class I was conducting before COVID-19 hit all of us, right? So this is the class that I was doing, the dissertation class, and these are the assignments which my students have submitted me, the qualitative content analysis, Amrita Sharma, and all the various students have submitted, the question, all those things are submitted. Let me quickly show you the another one. And then when I get these assignments, I also get to grade them. I open the assignment. The beautiful part of Google phone, in the phone while you get your assignments, is that while you're traveling, you're not moving around your laptop everywhere, right? From the phone, you can open your Google. The same thing has to be done. You create a classroom, enroll your students, exactly the steps that we have taught you, spoken to you about on the hard desk, on the laptop, or on the desktop, same process in the phone, no change, just download the Google app, right? And then you start saying, okay, see, if you see, I've written over here, topic approved. She was doing dissertation with me, I'm her research guide, and the topic she wanted to connect, and that is approved. And then somebody was walking, content and the student has sent me two attachments, right? And I can read it at the go, at my level, I can read all of this. Okay. Then I'm going to also show you all the various classes. If you go down there, settings, that is a profile that you make for yourself. I'm taking you up and I will suggest you one very important tip for all of you, which I have learned from my experience. I'm sure Google Classroom also teaches as much, but what I have also learned, and I think that's very important, is that out of these all classes, create one class also, which will be only you. There's nobody to be there over there. And why? Because this is going to be like your repository, which means basically that is going to be only you, in which you have your content, your files, your assignments that you have made, your quizzes that you have made, your work that you have created that you want to share in the class 1920, in the class 2021, think maybe you're teaching the same subject or different levels of the subject. You put every content over there. It's like a library for your own self. What we say, a Google hard drive. You can just keep it at that creator class. You can give your name and say my repository or my library, in which all your content is stored. And from there, you just pull up your assignments and send to whichever class that you want to send. It really helps. That's just a small tip that anybody wants to use it. I think that really helps in a very big way. So moving on, the last but not the least few things that I would like to speak about. And then we'll go back to few things. There's something coming up. Okay, there's a calendar also over here to schedule your classes. I'll just quickly open this calendar over here. In my phone, I'm showing you through my phone. This is all the details on the phone. And it has a month view. It has it gives me a day schedule. It gives you a timetable in the Google Classroom. What time I have my class? Do I have it on the Thursday or Monday or whichever? It gives me all that. You can time-wise write your timetable. At 2 o'clock, I'm having a class with advertisement student. At 1 o'clock, I'm having an online teaching or learning session, things like that, that you can put in there. Then it also gives me a view, a week view. So week, how my timetable is looking. We always, teachers, professors, make our timetable that I'm teaching class one at 11 o'clock. I'm teaching class at TY. I'm teaching fourth standard. You make your weekly schedules or you make your monthly schedule. Like you see, all these things are visible in your calendar. So that's a very helpful thing when you're scheduling your day or the month for your particular classroom that you're working for. And then going back to it, just a second. Yeah, I was here with my phone. You can actually see that when I do this and open this FYBMM 17-18 class, I can show you that each class, if you can go on, it also shows, just a second. How many students you have. I'm open. MAPR class, master's program, had in 1917 students. Right now, which is the, this is the class we just made. We just made today morning. And we had 12 students, right? And we can go down again, 12 students, 10 students, 74 students, certificate courses, and so on. It gives you the very, very clarity. If you're doing any activities, it also comes over there. So it helps you. Now I'm going to walk in the class with you to help you understand how you create the, exactly what we did in this. We'll quickly do that. So here's the thing, that the top is a bulletin board, which I said you can create your theme, then you create your class. I'm touching the class, giving the assignment, and I'm saying I'm assignment 3 unit. I'm giving the topic assignment 3 unit work, and I have written what instructions I've written. Each student doing unit 2 units to research and create all the details. And you can add marks to them. There you go. Very important. You write points. You give them for the grading, for the marking. It allows you assessment on the go. You have a choice. You can go ungraded or graded sensible when you do grading. and you put the time, date, and the time and the topic. So you put the grade. So when the students submit you, and then of course you say over here save, and then it's sent over there, right? So when they sent you over here, just okay. If you see over here, there's another notification, assignment two to be posted by all students as detailed given on the MAPR class. Extension of the date has been given till 5th October 2019. Now, very important to also understand that these things can be deleted or changed as per the need of the hour. So while we do this, how many have handed in? I'll show you that as well in the new class. Yes, Nehal Kambe, as we brought it to her, and this is qualitative analysis. So when she gets sending to me, you see these 3 points over here, right? When I touch the 3 points, and I want this to be, I have not assessed her work. I can say, if you look at bottom, move to top, delete or mute. What is mute? Mute means the student may comment or not comment till you have not assessed, or you do not want sometimes students write random comments. You can mute them till you have assessed and let them know. You say move to top. Now suddenly moving to top. Assignment which I had to do, that has gone suddenly on the top. See, Amrita Sharma has come on the top. That means this is the assignment. I have to check very quickly as a teacher and send it back to her. And I open her assignment. Her attachment is opening up. And she says, given me a PPT on entrepreneur PPTX. One more thing I would like to add on. As a teacher, when you want to say, you have checked students and you want to give them comment and work is not ready, there are two ways you can give a comment. One is class comment and one is again a individual comment. So class comment is when you give to every single person, it goes broadcasted what we showed you on this thing, that is, it goes to everybody or to selective. But when I open the assignment and I give a comment to her, it goes only to her. It goes only to Amrita Sharma and not for the class to read. Sometimes you want only to disclose certain comments, that changes have to be made and resubmission has to be done. So it allows her to read that particular comment. And you say, this is not well done, or this is very well done, and I'm very happy with your work. Well done. And you can put those comments. Let me also show you. There is certain to-do activities also there. We have a folder called enrolled, right? A to-do activities are done. You can to-do when certain tasks that teachers have to do. This folder can also be created on Google Classroom for your flipped classroom working at what content that you have to create and send to the students in the next upcoming assignment. So you can write over here and create a details for yourself as well. So that's the to-do list for yourself. And then I would like to show you. Okay, here we go. Social sciences class we have opened. And we are in the social sciences class right now. There is opening, right? We have opened this class, skill development that we were looking at as well. And when we get this thing, we want to again broadcast what the exam. This is over here. And while we do this, if I want to delete the work and make a fresh batch with this thing, whole thing, I can actually, as you see over here, it gives me the functionality of deleting also. This iPhone is not getting moved out. There's something written as delete over here, and you can delete that assignment, all the assignment, and get a fresh class started with all the headings, all intact. So that's also a beautiful aspect of given over here. So this is from my end of how you create a classroom, enter the Google Classroom, create a classroom, enroll your students. After enrolling your students, you can also enroll teachers for the various classrooms in two perspectives. You as a teacher plus another teacher, or you as a tutorial manager or the principal or a head of a management school, and you are only managing the whole thing and having other teachers teaching the various classes you created. And then we said how we serve the assignments and how the students receive and how they submit. So there are a lot of more things in Google Classroom. In this 1 hour module, I've tried to comprehend and put a lot of things together, but there's yet more to go. I wanted to show you how we could create a quiz also. And that's a very interesting way under the assignments and things that we can create a quiz also with the students in the assignment that we give. It allows us to open the Google Classroom, a Google form, create a quiz, and just get uploaded in a Google folder. And it's there for the students to MCQ the quizzes. Very beautifully, they get integrated. Thank you so much for the day today. A small part of Google Classroom, I would love to touch back on the last day because I really want to complete, but I can see many people are saying in the chat, it's time and they probably need to do other things. But I'm going to get back to Google Classroom and do a small one on the 7th day for all of you who want to continue learning on Google Classroom, and we'll lecture a little more towards the end part, which I think I must give you. So we had talked about creating a class, enrolling students, assigning students assignments, submitting and receiving from them. This is what we do, but I would also like to go a little more beyond, but that I will bring it in the last class of the session of this weekend, of the week-long sessions. And I promise I'm going to do it for those who are interested. And thank you from my side. And I hope you had a good time, good learning, practice well, not at all difficult. I just started this in 2017-18. It's not a rocket science. We all can do it. And it's really easy. Digital learning is really easy, not tough. It just affects, which is our self-imposed limitations, right? But we can all do it. I trust each one of you sitting right here, Arun Bhoyer, Azaz Malik, Radha, Arjun, Suhail, Dr. Kuldeep Kumar, Sayyid, Jaymala Thakur, Dr. Ishad Ahmed, Deepak, Jesse, Professor BK, Dr. Marufa, all of you, Parma Sivasan, all and more people. I can see so many beautiful people here, Dr. Srinivasan, Dr. Shalini, and Ajay Kumar, and Tanuja. All you all have the power in you. We all are teachers. If we can't empower ourselves, I don't believe that. I don't buy that argument. You have it in you. Yes. All we need is patience and the willpower. We have to do it and take the initiative. And let me tell you, congratulate all of you have already taken the initiative. The very fact all of you are here in this journey together with us. I want you all to write yes in the chat box right now. Are you ready to walk ahead? Because you have already in the initiative. You have already taken the initiative. You can do it. Just write yes, I can. All of you, I would like them to write it there. That confidence, self-building has to come in because you've started the journey. Sharda, Shyama, Lakbir, Rosalind, Suman Bala, I'm so glad you could come in. Aranya, Arjun, Dr. Aditya, Srinivasan, Mudassir, Vaishali, Sarita, Sampada, Shravi, Rumaina, Priya Darshan, so many beautiful people right here. Congratulations for having embarked on this journey of digital teaching and of course learning too. You're always the thirst of hunger of learning has to be there in the teacher as much as it is in the student. Only then we are effective teachers, because we are effective learners for our lifetime. Age is just a number game. Please remember that. Age is just a number game. We are learners till we do not stop, right? So happy learning and happy teaching and happy empowering self and the society. Thank you one and all, and we'll meet again. And I promise you, I'm going to come back to you with Google Classroom, the small bit which I want to add on to this on the last day of this whole session when they all end up. I'm going to bring the small addition. Till then, namaskar, be safe, be healthy, namaste.